See, the farmers always use such kind of natural techniques so that the natural fertility of the soil can be maintained and natural fertility of the soil can be increased. Okay. So, first, okay, and now first of all, what we are studying now, advantages. Advantages of what? This. Natural methods. What are the advantages of natural methods? Okay. So, what can be the advantage of natural method? Use of natural methods improves the fertility of the soil naturally. Okay, so what is the use of natural methods improves the fertility of soil naturally? That means what? Just we have to connect the points. That means use of manures and fertilizers can be what? Reduced or increased? It can be reduced. Okay, now very important thing, if we keep on growing same crop, the pest, it becomes very easy for the pest to attack the crops. So I have discussed this thing somewhere before also, pest chain gets broken, very important thing. Okay, pest chain gets broken. That means suppose in a field a crop is attacked by a pest. Okay, now in the next, if the crop is being rotated in the next season, the next crop is there, so what will happen? The pest do not like, it will become a little difficult for the pest, because the same pest won't be attacking the other crop. Okay, now it is being observed, it is being noticed that pest attack rarely on multiple crops. Okay, what is being observed? That pest attack rarely on multiple crops. That means they do not, they are not very well comfortable, I should say, in this way. Because they are, every time they are having some new crops. Okay, so the pest attack rarely on the multiple crops. Okay, so these are the advantages why the natural methods should be used. Like, why it should be used? Natural methods should be used because it improves the fertility of the soil. Then use of manure and fertilizers can be reduced. Okay, then it breaks the pest chain. Okay, then pest attack rarely on the multiple crops. So these all are advantages, these all are the useful things, useful results due to which one should use natural, but like should adopt the natural means, like which we have studied just now, to leave the field fallow, to use the methods of crop rotation, multiple rotation. Okay, now see, from the beginning of the chapter only we are studying about some one or the other different processes or the different steps of sowing the crops or sowing the seeds, or some various steps are there. We read about the preparing of the soil, tilling, then sowing. Okay, so now before this we also studied about the manures, fertilizers, some different methods, how the fertility of the soil can be used. Now next we are going to read, next we are going to read about the irrigation. Okay, now what is the meaning of irrigation? We all are aware about that. Okay, So now the next topic is irrigation. Okay. Now what is the meaning of irrigation? Okay. Now what we are going to read? Irrigation. First of all, as we will be writing definition, so what is the meaning of irrigation? To supply water to the crops in particular intervals. Okay, what's the meaning of irrigation? To supply water to the crops in different intervals. Okay, so why we need to give water, like what is the use of giving water? Okay, so we'll just have a question. Why to irrigate the fields? Okay, what's the need of giving water to the land? See, for us also to be alive, water is required. Okay, so we'll just have a quick look upon the reasons why the soil needs to be irrigated. So first of all, for a proper growth and development of the crops. Okay, why it has to be irrigated? Why the field need to be irrigated? So that proper growth and development of the crops can takes place. Okay, we all know without water we can't survive. Even the plants are living beings, and so there's no question of plants of even the plants can't survive. There's no doubt about that. So for the proper growth and development, okay, if we look into this little bit more, you know, in a very particular way, so it is required for germination of seeds. If the seeds do not get proper water, or if the seeds do not have proper amount of moisture inside it or in the soil, so what will happen? The seeds won't be able to germinate. The seed won't be able to germinate. The saplings won't. You won't be able to see saplings. Okay, now for the blooming, like, you know, when the flowers has to bloom, they need extra water. For the development of flowers and fruits. Okay, more water has to be, more nutrient has to be given during the flowering period. Okay, so without water, obviously you won't be able to see blossoming of the flowers. Flowers won't be seen. Okay, then, okay, what can be the next one? Like, first of all, when we talk about the seeds, seed won't germinate. Okay, now, you know, when the root absorb nutrients from the soil, how it can be absorbed? If the water is not there, like, see, all the nutrients get dissolved into water and the water is absorbed, okay, and the nutrients are there in the water. Okay, so nutrients are dissolved in water and then it is translocated in the field. So for the translocation or for the absorption, or I should write translocation, for the translocation of the nutrients. Okay, for the translocation of nutrients means what? For the movement of nutrients First of all, the roots are going to absorb water. In this water, the nutrients are dissolved, and these nutrients are going to reach to the different parts of the plant with the help of what? Water only. So, for the translocation of the nutrients also, the water is required, water is needed. Okay, we can write n number of things over here, but the main thing is what? To be like for the to keep the plant alive, okay, to keep the plant alive. Now when I say to keep the plant alive, why? Because in absence of water, all these mechanisms won't take place. So automatically plant is going to die. Now when we talk about photosynthesis, okay, we all know in photosynthesis, okay, in photosynthesis, water is a raw material or water is required. Water is required. Okay, we all know this, we are reading from the very childhood. What is photosynthesis? When like plant absorb nutrients, okay, in presence of sunlight, carbon dioxide is there, chlorophyll, but if water is not there, will the leaves will be able to prepare the food? No, that means photosynthesis cannot take place in absence of water. So what all these points are about? These all points are about why irrigation is important. Okay, first of all, what is irrigation? To supply water, to give water, okay, to give water to whom? To give water to the crops, okay, in a field in different intervals, during different intervals, okay. So this is what irrigation. Now why irrigation is necessary? Just now we have read everything, like for the proper growth and development of the plant, for the germination of seeds, for the development of flowers and fruits, for the absorption or translocation of the nutrients, for the plant to be alive, for the process of photosynthesis, okay. So this is why the irrigation is important. You know, in country like of us, like India, when we talk about especially, the rate of irrigation is very low. Can you understand the meaning of rate of irrigation? The rate of irrigation means to provide, the rate of providing water to the crop is very low. Then you must be thinking, then how the crops can be alive? The simple thing is, in our country still the farmers depend upon only the monsoon, okay, monsoons. That means if the monsoon is good, then they will be able to have good crops, and if the monsoon fails for one odd year, then the crops are not to the mark, okay. So if we talk about, you know, just an rough average, like rough estimate, that how much percent of land is totally irrigated, just for the sake of knowledge, 18% only, 18% of land is totally irrigated. That means only this much percent of land is irrigated properly, is given water at the required interval, at the possible whatever the requirements are there, okay. Now around 24% of crops, they are partially irrigated. Now what is meaning of partially irrigated? That means one odd time the water is given, the very next time again, like, no, something like some part is lacking, not fully irrigated but at least partially irrigated. Rest, that means just see, only this much, I said this part in the beginning of this chapter, that our country is an agriculture based country, okay. Most of the people are directly or indirectly is in this, like they are related to agriculture. Still, this, see the amount, the average of irrigation. Only 18% totally irrigated and 24% is partially irrigated, you know. And the way of irrigation, now we are going to talk something about the traditional methods and the modern methods. Or first of all, I just want to say that we are going to read about the ways of irrigation, okay, how the water has to be given. Before that, I'll have to rub the board. So, okay. So, first of all, to get water from somewhere, that means there should be some sources, okay. So, before reading the methods, like how the water is given to the field, we will just talk about how the So, we will just talk about the sources of irrigation, okay, from where the farmers can get the water. So, we are going to read about sources of irrigation, okay. So, I will not write 1 and 2, just what can be the different sources of irrigation. It can be rivers, okay. It can be wells, it can be tube wells, okay. It can be some reservoirs, okay. So, what can be the different sources of irrigation? It can be river, wells, tube wells, reservoirs. From here, okay, from here again, it is not very easy to supply water to the crops, okay. So, see, water is available all over here. Now, we have like farmers, whenever I am saying we, it means farmers, okay. So, the farmers has to supply water from here to the crops. How? What can be the means? So, they use sometimes pumps, sometimes channels, sometimes furrows, okay. So, different things like different means are used. Okay, pumps can be like, you know, like petrol pumps can be used, diesel pumps can be used, okay. Sometimes the solar pumps can be used, sometimes electric pumps can be used, okay. See, what we are talking about? We are talking about the sources of irrigation. So, we have different kind, like the farmers take water from the different places, like it can be rivers, it can be wells, tube wells and reservoirs. Now, from these places, okay, from these places, water has to be given to the field. It has to reach to the crops. So, what the farmers can use, how they can use? Pumps, channels, furrows, okay. We are going to discuss petrol, like which kind of pumps can be used, maybe all these. Petrol pump, diesel pump, solar pump, electric pumps, you know. So, these can be used. So, when we talk about the ways of irrigation, okay, when we talk about ways of irrigation, it can be divided into two. Now, I will be talking about ways of irrigation. Now, I should write over here, ways, okay, ways of irrigation. So, first of all, ways of irrigation can be divided into two, okay. The first can be traditional ways, okay, and second can be modern ways, okay. Traditional ways, I won't be discussing much about this. It can be, I can write pulley system, moat, okay, and even the lever system, maybe Rahat, Dekli, okay. all these systems can be used, or like are these all are the traditional system which were used, maybe used now in some or the other fields in the interior of India, okay, in the interior parts. So to start with, traditional ways. Now these are what? Pulley system, moat, lever system, rahat and dekhli. So what are these? You know, what actually farmers do, they have to take out the water from the wells, from a reservoir, from a tank. And how it has to be done? Like generally, I'll just give you a small example. Like suppose this is a well, okay, the water has to be taken out, has to be removed from here. So for this, they use maybe some, like most of the time they use animals, okay. The animals, sometimes they use it in a way, the animals just moves around, keep on moving round and round, and some containers are over here which get dipped into the water, into the well, and the water keeps on filling, and like by the time again it gets turned over here and the water falls over here, and again here the channels are here, that means some way for the water to go, and the water comes into this and the water flows. What it is? A reservoir or a tank from the water has to be filled up. So the farmers many a times they use animals, animals move, due to which the this containers of the water keep on get, like it gets filled, again it get emptied over here, and here sort of channels are there, due to which the water get reaches to the different parts of the field and the fields get irrigated. Here like many a times the pulleys are used, okay. The containers are being made, the containers are lot many containers are attached, and to that motor is attached. Due to motor, the this thing is rotating, again get filled up and the water comes out, okay. So what is there? Like in traditional ways, manpower is used, sometimes animal power is used, and even the machineries are used, okay. So now we are going to talk about modern ways. Okay, now what can be the modern ways? I'll just write, first of all, it can be furrows, okay, first. Second, like what we are talking about, we are talking about modern ways in which I am writing furrows. Second can be basin. Third can be sprinkle method, and the fourth can be drip irrigation. Okay, what we are talking about? We are talking about modern ways, how the fields are irrigated now, okay. Furrows, basin, sprinkle method and drip irrigation, or sprinkle irrigation, even you can write irrigation over here, okay. So now to begin with, what is furrows? Okay, now furrows means what? Just now I explained that furrows means what? A sort of the way, a sort of the way is made so that the water can go to reach to the different parts of the field. So what is furrow? So what it is, in this method, water is allowed to move in a channel, okay. Means what it is, in this method water is allowed to move in a channel. Through this channel the water reaches to the wherever the crops are there, the channels are automatically, like they are made in this way that the water reaches to the particular crop, So it is a definition of what? Furrows. It is the first one. Okay. It is what? Furrows. Now, second is what? Basin. Okay. Now, in basin, what is being done actually? Water is allowed to get like water is allowed to be collected. Okay. Water is collected over there. Say the example of paddy or rice. Okay, paddy, rice, one and the same thing. Means what has to be done here? Water is collected. Okay. Or the water is collected means allowed to be there, get stagnant over there in the field. Okay. Water is collected in the field. Because some crops need continuous, they need more and more water. So what has to be done? This is known as what? Basin system. Means what? The water is there in the field, crops are there in the standing in the field, and water, like, it is filled up in the field. Now, sprinkle irrigation and drip irrigation. Sprinkle irrigation. I think I need to rub board now. Okay. Now, what is sprinkle irrigation? Now, first of all, sprinkle irrigation is very useful where the land is unleveled. Unleveled land. Okay. Like unleveled land means what? When it is not very even. Okay. When it's not, the channels can't be made. Okay, because the land is uneven, if it is up and down and not very even, so channels, the water can't move up. Okay, it can come down only. So when the land is uneven, sprinkle methods are used. Also, it is used where sandy soil is present. Okay, where the I should write, where the retaining capacity, okay, the soil retaining cap, the water retaining capacity of the soil is less. It is used where the water retaining capacity used where water retaining capacity of the soil is less. See, now what actually sprinkle system is? It is like, I can say, it is like a, I'll draw here, a pipe is there, okay, a horizontal, I should say perpendicular, sorry, a perpendicular pipe is there. This is connected with the main source somewhere, okay, and to this a perpendicular pipe is attached. Here one nozzle is attached, okay, one nozzle is attached which is having holes in it, which is having what? Holes in it. Now this nozzle, it has a capacity of rotating, okay, after few minutes it rotates, okay. Now what is happening when the water is there here and is there in somewhere in the pipes? Now when it is, when the switches are on, when the motor is on, what will happen? The water will rush here. It will come up in the perpendicular tubes with a force, and this forced water comes out. The water is coming in the force. It is very, very important. The water comes with the force and it comes out from this nozzle in the form of the sprinkle. Sprinkle means what? How the raindrops comes. Okay, when we pour the water like this, cheetah, just come with the cheetah, right? So the water is coming up in the form of the raindrops. Okay, so what happens, you know, like this is the mouth of the nozzle. From this part the water is coming. After some time, what will happen? After a minute or something, like some interval of time, it will move this side. So this part will get irrigated, then again this part, so it keeps on rotating in the field. Like this part rotating in the field means what? It doesn't move, go somewhere. This sprinkle irrigation, main line perpendicular pipe. To this sprinkles, the nozzles are arranged and it moves, it rotates on this perpendicular rod and the water is given to the different areas, like many sprinkle, like many the sprinkles are there in one field. So whenever whatever area needs water, whatever area needs to be irrigated, that sprinkle is switched on, this nozzle is switched on, this pipeline is switched on and the water reaches over there. So what is the special thing, why it is used? See, first of all, the water doesn't get collected anywhere, it moves in the form of the raindrops. So the if the water is less, then also it is like this kind of method is used. Okay, then every part of the field get watered, and the like, you know, due to overwater also the crops get destroyed. We are going to study that also. So it, like, there are no chance of like any time that the crops are over irrigated. Okay, so this was about the sprinkle irrigation. Now we are going to talk about the drip irrigation. Now the fourth one, drip irrigation. Now what is the meaning of drip irrigation? Drip irrigation means what? The pipelines are there, okay, in the field the pipelines are there. Now here suppose the plants are there, so these pipelines have particular like hole. It is arranged in this way that the water from these pipes, they reaches on to the roots or to the like around the roots, okay. So what is there we are talking about? What we are talking about? Drip irrigation. Now where the drip irrigation can be used? It can be used where the scarcity of water is there. That means the water is available in very less amount. Okay, where drip irrigation can be used? Drip irrigation can be used where the water, like in the areas where the water is not available. Water is available in very very less amount. Okay, so what is drip irrigation? Boond boond. Okay, like it is given boond boond, like very in a very stingy way. Okay, so what has to be done? Pipes are there, pipes has holes, this holes, from the holes the water comes out and the water reaches to the roots or onto the surface somewhere over there. So it is done specially in the areas where the water scarcity is there. Okay, so what we have studied now, ways of irrigation. First is, like, it can be divided into two ways, traditional ways and modern ways. When we talk about traditional ways, what are the traditional ways? Maybe pulley system, moat, lever system, rahat, dekli. Okay, so all these can be the traditional ways. In traditional ways also, what are being used, what are the things which is used? Maybe manpower, maybe animal power, maybe the pumps, maybe like machineries are also used. Okay, now the second is modern ways of irrigation. So what are the things? Furrows, basin, sprinkle irrigation and drip irrigation. Furrows means to make the channels into the field so that the water reaches to the every part of the field. Basin, to collect the water in the particular area, field, okay, like paddy. Sprinkle, this one, a pipe, to this a perpendicular pipe is attached, nozzle is attached and the water keeps, like this nozzle rotates and the water reaches to that particular like wherever till whatever area it is about to fall. Okay, now next is drip irrigation. The water comes with the form of the drops, with the help of the pipelines the water reaches to the soil or onto the roots. Okay, so these were about this, we are talking about what? Irrigation, the ways of irrigation. Now see, everything has to be in the limit. Okay, it's very good that we are irrigating the fields. Again I'm saying, when we talk about we, that means farmers. Okay, so it is good that the farms are being irrigated. Okay, and we also read that why it is important to irrigate the farms. Okay, but if the irrigation is not done properly. So what will happen? See, one case we all can understand, okay, which case? That if it is not irrigated properly, means which way, like the less irrigation, if the water is not provided in the quantity it is supposed to be, okay, so what will happen? The crops won't grow, right? The crops won't grow. So